Hey everyone, and welcome to TopThink. Today, we're going to learn 8 mind-blowing theories about your brain. Now, let's begin. The human brain is the most complex object in our known universe. With 100 billion nerve cells and over 100 trillion synapses, this intricate neural network has both fascinated and frustrated scientists for decades. Even after significant advances in biotechnology, scientists are still struggling to uncover all that the human brain has to offer. But we are getting closer and closer every day. While we don't have a complete understanding of how everything works, leading experts have stumbled upon several earth-shattering discoveries. We're not just talking about a few new facts and figures. These theories call into question all kinds of fundamental cognitive concepts. They turn everything from perception to consciousness on its head. Despite volumes of supportive research, many people like to pretend that these theories don't exist, but the truth is right around the corner. These revolutionary concepts may transform the way you view life, reality, and the world around you. So let's go ahead and dive into 8 theories about your brain that will blow your mind. Number 1. Passive frame theory. What exactly does your conscious brain do? Most people assume your consciousness interprets and interacts with the world. They see it like a middleman between your body and the environment. When something happens, your consciousness has the free will to choose how to behave. For example, when a ball rolls towards you, your consciousness decides whether to kick it, pick it up, or do nothing. But passive frame theory challenges this basic assumption. It proposes that our consciousness plays a more passive role. It doesn't have any choice or free will. It simply provides possible options which other parts of the brain use to stimulate action. So, when that ball comes rolling towards you, your consciousness doesn't tell you what to do. Think about your consciousness like a search engine. You can look up how to kick a ball, but that's just information. You don't have to behave a certain way simply because you know you can. This means your consciousness serves as a passive observer. It pays attention to external stimuli and cognitive data, but doesn't actually decide anything. What it can do is provide justification. After you kick the ball, your consciousness uses all that information to explain why the ball was kicked. This creates the illusion of choice. It seems like you have control. You believe you took action for a specific reason. But it's really your consciousness justifying a series of automatic impulses. In simpler terms, we might be giving our consciousness way too much credit. Number 2. Single neuron theory. What if consciousness existed on a smaller scale? We usually think about the entire brain as one conscious entity, but this theory suggests the complete opposite. It says that your brain is comprised of 100 billion conscious cells. Each one has its own subjectivity, its own independent impact on your brain. Now, of course, not every neuron is created equal. Some have little to no consciousness, while others are extremely influential. The difference depends on where the neuron is located in your brain. Neurons in cognitively complex places like the prefrontal cortex would outweigh neurons in the hypothalamus, which controls mostly unconscious functions. But if each neuron has its own consciousness, how does anything get done? Well, our brain may only activate one group of neurons at a time. Your consciousness seems singular and unified because only a few neurons are speaking their minds. Number 3. Time slices. Humans have invented and organized ways of understanding time. It's continuous, consistent, and fluid. But do our brains conceptualize it the same way? Time slice theory breaks temporal processing into 2 stages. At first, we unconsciously perceive vague pieces of information. It's almost like a long series of very blurry frames. These only last about 400 milliseconds, or 0.4 seconds. In each one, you identify basic colors and forms. It isn't until stage 2 that you hone in on the actual details. At this point, your consciousness figures out what's actually happening. You give each sliver some sort of meaning and decide if it's important. That way, you know where to store each slice of time in your memory. So, how does this theory change our perception of time? Instead of one continuous system, your brain experiences time as a string of tiny moments. To you, time feels consistent and coherent. But it's actually a trick that your brain uses to make your life a little easier. Number 4. Panpsychism. Panpsychism alters the way we conceptualize consciousness. Normally, we attribute subjective consciousness to a select few organisms. We classify it as a higher cognitive process. That means it's reserved for only the most neurologically developed species. But panpsychism suggests a completely different approach. This theory proposes that every material thing in the universe has some fragment of consciousness. Every atom, whether it's part of a rock or a living cell, can have experiences. They have consciousness, even if it's just a tiny, tiny bit. If this sounds strange to you, don't worry, you're not alone. Panpsychism has been widely criticized for how counterintuitive it sounds. How could something as simple as an electron be conscious? How do non-living objects have experiences? It's challenging to wrap your head around, but that doesn't mean it isn't true. Panpsychism has grown in popularity over the years by offering one of the most plausible explanations for the birth of consciousness. Few questions have stumped scientists more than this one. Where did human consciousness come from? Why are some animals conscious while the rest of the universe isn't? There have been hundreds of different theories. However, none have properly explained how consciousness actually emerged. Panpsychism answers this question by nullifying it. If every material thing can experience, then human consciousness never needed to emerge. It's been there all along. It's a fundamental part of your existence. Every building block in your body has a small but relevant sense of subjectivity. That means human consciousness is just a product of evolution. Of course, this theory has the same problem as just about every other theory related to consciousness. There's very little definitive proof, but it does offer a logical and, more importantly, possible explanation of human subjectivity. So, while it sounds exceptionally strange, panpsychism is one of the best theories we've got. Number 5. Integrated Information Theory. Can you measure consciousness? It seems like such an intangible concept. The act of quantifying consciousness feels too abstract and nuanced to really yield anything worthwhile. That's where Integrated Information Theory, or IIT, comes into play. In the simplest terms, IIT says consciousness is created by integrating a huge volume of stimuli. Our brain combines all that information into a single experience. You can therefore quantify the amount of consciousness something has by analyzing the complexity of its brain. It gets a lot more complicated from there, but that's pretty much the gist of it. This theory began with a pretty simple observation. Neuroscientists noticed that the most complex parts of the brain play the largest role in conscious thought. The more essential something is, the more intricate it gets. But here's the problem with IIT. We don't really know how to accurately measure neural complexity. We're not completely clueless, but scientists are still working on a reliable way to understand the brain. Whoever figures that out just might unlock the first accurate measurement of consciousness. Number 6. Branching minds. This might be the most challenging concept to wrap your head around. It's based on an older theory called the many worlds interpretation. Essentially, there are an infinite number of branching realities in which everything that can happen has happened. Each time an event occurs, it creates a new set of realities in which that event unfolds differently. An extension of the many worlds theory, titled the many minds interpretation, claims that branching isn't happening to our reality. Instead, the split happens in your mind. Your subjective experience of the world is what changes after each event. Every outcome triggers a different mental state, which subsequently limits your brain to a single perspective. That means that every consciousness interacts with a diverse spectrum of minds, but the only one that you can experience is yours. Number 7. Conscious electricity. Your perception might not come from the construction of your brain. A group of scientists in the United Kingdom discovered that both awareness and perception correlate with disturbances in the electromagnetic field around your brain. Their research suggests that meaning might come from a unique electromagnetic field. Its primary job is to bind neural responses together, which creates the illusion of singular perception. An important piece of evidence for this theory comes from a study conducted on rabbits. Researchers found that the field around the rabbit's brain changed shape in response to different smells. This transformation may be responsible, or at least influential, in the creation of meaning. This theory has a lot of room to grow. At this point, all we know is that electricity plays a bigger role in the brain than we thought. Number 8. Orchestrated objective reduction. Orchestrated objective reduction, or ORC-OR, explains consciousness as a collection of biological signals from each neuron. This theory is actually a few decades old. Back then, it was rejected by the scientific community. No one believed neurons could be so structurally complicated. A study from 2014 has given ORC-OR new life. Researchers discovered vibrations coming from individual neurons. Consciousness, therefore, could be a combination of billions of tiny vibrations. If this were true, each of your neurons would have a small amount of input on your total consciousness. It's almost like voting in an election. Each person casts their vote, but in the end, the majority rules. To put this theory to the test, researchers tried to influence those neural vibrations. If ORC-OR were true, this should have some positive or negative effect on consciousness. And that's exactly what happened. This change caused significant differences in both mood and voluntary behavior. Who knew that such tiny vibrations could be so powerful? Hey, thank you for watching Top Think, and be sure to subscribe, because more incredible content is on the way.